I remember playing the very first Mortal Kombat game in an arcade in the 90s while my parents weren't looking, and I've been a fan of the franchise ever since. There was this one thing in Mortal Kombat games that I hadn't seen in any other games before, apart from the copious amount of blood and gore, and that is the toasty guy. When you do a down two, an uppercut, or a fatality, there was a dude that would appear in the corner of the screen and goes, "Toasty!" And it was the funniest thing ever. Anyways, fast forward to now. I make content for live streamers, so today I'm gonna show you two different ways to get the toasty guy, or even yourself, to pop on screen using OBS Studio and StreamerBot. But before we start, this video is sponsored by no one. Enjoy.
Round one. Fight.
So here we are in OBS Studio, and basically the first method, which is the easiest, is to find a green screen version of it on YouTube, download it, put it in your OBS Studio as a media source, and just turn it on and off, of course, with a chroma key filter. Let me demonstrate. So we're gonna go to YouTube, and we're gonna type green screen, if I can type, toasty. You're gonna find multiple versions, but I want this one because it's the most recognizable for me. So now I'm gonna copy the link, and then I'm gonna find a way to download it. I like using notube.io, like paste the link, make sure you have MP4 HD, although HD doesn't really matter here. Then click télécharger. I'm gonna save it. Now back to OBS Studio. You could add it as a simple source, but personally, I have a scene where I put all of my green screen footage. So when I have to trigger them, I can just add this scene as a source. So right here, you're gonna see green screen videos, and it's gonna be empty. That's because I make StreamerBot basically trigger those whenever someone redeems them.
Wow, a little bit spicy.
Let them come.
Are you sure about this?
Enemy spotted.
And when it plays in here, basically it's gonna appear on my other screens. So to add what we downloaded, we're gonna click on the plus here to add a new source. We're gonna go and find media source because it's a video. We're gonna call this one Toasty. Click OK. Click browse and go find it wherever you downloaded it. I can see it right there. Click OK. There it is. Now right now we're not hearing it. It is playing technically through OBS Studio, so Stream, for example, would be able to hear it. But much like an alert, we also want to be able to hear it. So I'm gonna find it in my audio mixer. I'm gonna click here and go to advanced audio properties. Then under Toasty here, we're gonna find monitor only mute output.
Toasty!
So if you wanna play it, just turn it off and turn it back on again.
Toasty!
And here it is. Now for the sake of testing it and adding the chroma key filter, I'm gonna double click on it and put it on loop so it doesn't ever stop, basically.
Toasty!
You can also pause it, just like that. Then you can click on filters or right click on it, click filters. And we're gonna click plus and we're gonna find chroma key. Chroma key, click OK. I'm satisfied with those, with the settings, with the default settings. So let's click close and we're pretty much done. If I go to the full screen here, since I already have that scene added, it's gonna be right there. But of course, we don't want it to be paused. So let's play it, let's double click and let's not loop it anymore. Now we're gonna be using StreamerBot just to do this. Turn it off when it's done, turn it back on when I want, and then turn it off. So let's open up StreamerBot. Okay, from here, we can see that we're connected. I'm gonna go to action. I'm gonna right click to add a brand new one. We're gonna name this one Toasty. I'm gonna put it in a group if you have one. I already have a group just for my green screens. And I'm gonna click okay. All right, while it's selected, I'm gonna go to sub actions. And remember, we just wanted to play, wait a little bit, and then stop. Right click, go to OBS, go to sources, go to set source visibility state, and click on that. Now we have to select our source. So the scene is green screen videos indeed, and the source is Toasty. The state is gonna be visible, and we're gonna click okay. Now we're gonna right click to add the delay. So this is what's gonna make it wait. We're gonna go to core, we're gonna go to delay, and we need to know how long we want it to last for. And if I hover over this, it says 2 seconds. So here in delay, I'm gonna put 2000, because that's 2000 milliseconds, as it says here. Click that, and then I want another source visibility state. So I'll right click on the first one and I'll click duplicate sub action. It'll appear at the bottom. I'll double click to open up the settings and I'll make it hidden. Then I click okay, and that should be it. We're done with the actions. Now you can choose how you want it to be triggered. I personally like doing channel points on Twitch, but if, for example, you're not using Twitch or you would like to have something else, all of that is included in StreamerBot. Figure it out. So I'm gonna go to platforms, and under Twitch, I can see channel point rewards, but of course you can also see cheers, you'll see subs, resubs, gift, raids, hype train, and all that. So let's go channel point rewards, And as you can see, I have a bunch of groups also. I'm going to right click and I'm going to click add. I'm going to call this one Toasty. The prompt will be Toasty from Mortal Kombat. Then here you can set the cost. I'm just going to be testing it, so I'm keeping it at 1. There's also cooldown per person, per streams and all that. I'll put it in a group, green screen effects. And this is where you select the action that you created. There, we're going to scroll down until we find Toasty. Where is it? Right there. Click select, click OK. And when you go back to your Twitch chat, you should be able to see a new channel point. I should have a dock here with chat. There it is. And when I go to channel points, I'm going to see Toasty. It's currently visible and we don't want that because it's supposed to start by being hidden, right? Because the first action is to make it visible. So I'm going to click on it. I'm going to click redeem. It should work.
Toasty!
Just like that. Now let's go to my full screen scene. Hi. And I have it right there as a scene, as you can see. So that's what you would want to do if you don't have it as a scene already. So that's how easy it is. Now, personally, I would like for it to be my face instead of Den for Den. Sorry, Den. So what I can do is take a picture of myself, remove the background, and I'm actually going to use the move transition plugin to actually make it move around. So I don't need any external, I don't need video editing software to do this.
Round 2, fight.
In fact, I'm just going to take a screenshot of myself right now. So I press Windows Shift S for the snipping tool. I'm going to select the area that I want. And then I'm going to open up my browser. I'm going to go to photopea.com or Photopea. It's going to know automatically the size of whatever I have in the clipboard. Click new project. That's the exact size. Click create and then control V, just like that. This is completely free, by the way. I'm going to go to one of the select tools like the magic wand tool, and then I'm going to go to select subject. Nice. As you can see, it selected me. Of course, if your background is a little cleaner, it will be even better. Then I'm going to go down under the layer list and I'm going to click add raster mask, just like that. What was that? 2-3 clicks. Cool. I'm going to shut down the background and I'm going to do some extra stuff that you don't have to do, but I'm going to add an adjustment layer just to make sure that the colors are right. I'm going to drag the handles here to have a bunch of contrast. There we go. I'm going to drag this one and that's it. I'm going to go file, export as PNG, save. And that's it. Now let's animate it in OBS Studio. Now, even though it's not a green screen footage, I'm still going to put it in my green screen scene just because it's a scene that's transparent that I already have on my other scenes. Click plus under the source list. And this time we're going to add an image because that's what we created. Toasty G for Gil. Browse to find it. It's right there. Click open. Nice. I could have refined the edges, but I don't care. And let's say that I want it to appear like this. Okay. So it's going to be bottom corner. I already have the move transition plugin. First of all, go watch a basic tutorial on it. So here's what we're going to do. We need two filters, one for when it's on screen and another one for when it's off screen. The move source filter only works on groups or scenes, which is cool because we actually want the audio of the Toasty. So we're still going to keep this. So we're actually going to group up my Toasty and the original Toasty together. I'm going to hold shift, click on the second one, right click, and then up top, group selected items. I'm going to call this one Toast Group. Nice. Technically, you could just download the audio and put your face and do the animation. But since we already have this, it will serve us as a pretty good reference. Okay, so now that we have them as a group, I could add the filter to the group. But in order for this to be more reliable, is just what I found with this move transition plugin. I will add it to the scene itself. So I'm going to go to filters. I'm going to go to plus. And I'm going to go to move source, click OK. So the first one should be the final position. Basically, how do you want it to look once it's on screen or where you want it to be? So I'm going to call this one on screen. And under source, I want to be able to pick the group, the toast group, for example. And I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to click get transform. That means it recorded the position of the group. Now I'm going to duplicate this, right click, duplicate. Nice. And this should be off screen, right? Nice, what it's selected, you wanna go down. You see position is 0 here. You wanna make sure you're selecting the right group here and then you wanna move it on the horizontal line. And now you click get transform and you should see the position change. Nice. That's pretty much it. You can click on screen visibility to see if it works and then off screen. There you go. Now we just need to create an action in StreamerBot that tells it to do this and that. As simple. We can definitely play around with the timing. So custom duration, we can go to on screen. We're gonna try to make it the same. Let's go with 700. That might be a little slow. Let's test it. Actually, that's kind of perfect. Cool. But we have a problem. Our problem is that we have the original Toasty and it's a video. That's just my problem. If you have just an audio, you should be fine.
Toasty!
We want it to play the sound, but we don't want it to play the video. So I'm gonna select it individually. Make sure I play it and pause it so it's still selectable, basically. And then I'm gonna click and drag it out of frame. So we'll just hear the audio. Again, just download the audio if you want to do this step. I'm just doing this because, well, that's it. Because it's already there and I don't fear for my computer specs. And now let's create the scene in StreamerBot, or the action first. Let's right click, click add. Actually, I'm just going to edit the one that I already created because I do want to use this on my stream. So it's called Toasty. I'm just going to delete all of those. So what are the steps? Make the Toasty sound visible. Move my image in frame using the move filter. Wait about 700 milliseconds. Move it out of frame and hide the Toasty sound. And we do that by right clicking OBS, sources, set source visibility state, tongue twister. Toasty is the visibility we want. We want it to be visible. Cool. Right click, OBS, scenes, because the filter, the move transition filter, is on the scene. Set scene filter state. Nice. The filter we want to be on is on screen. That's our move to be on screen. And we want to set it to visible. Nice. Now we want to introduce the delay. We're going to go to core, delay. I'm going to make it 800 milliseconds just to be sure. And then do the reverse. So I'm going to right click on this. I'm going to duplicate it, double click on it. And this time we want it to be on off screen. Click OK. The source visibility state for the quote unquote sound, right click, duplicate it, double click. And we want it to be hidden. There we go. 5 steps and we're ready. And that's it. Now, technically, I already set up this as my channel point, so I shouldn't have to modify anything under platform. It should already be somewhere there, right there. Now, just like before, we want to prep our scene. We want the Toasty sound to be hidden, of course. We want the Toasty G to be out of frame. So in the source filters, go there, click off screen. I don't know what happened there, but it moved in the wrong direction. Okay, that's weird. I'm gonna record them again. So on screen, I want you to be, let's say there. So on screen, get transform, then off screen, be off screen, get transform. Okay, I don't know why that was different, but let's test it out. So it should appear on my full screen scene. Hi again. And let's just redeem it. So this is what we created. It's just that simple. It is just that simple. Once again, this is what we made.
Toasty.
And there you have it. If you have any cool ideas, if you replicate this, post it, tag me on Twitter. I love seeing when you guys do things based on my tutorials. This one was super simple, but if you want more advanced StreamerBot stuff, make sure you check out my other StreamerBot videos. And with that, I will say thank you so much for watching. Go out there, make me proud, get level. Out.
Flawless victory.